Good morning.
Good morning.
Come on, you do better at this.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. That sounds better. Hey, welcome to worship at Peace United Methodist Church. Today is a special day, special in the sense of three things. One, we're going to have the children celebrating children, which is our future today. Second, today is the sixth of August, 2023, the day we never come back. And what puts it together all special, we also do the communion, the sacred sacrament. So I think it's special today. In addition, we get to see some of the finest people in the Fox Valley. That's you guys are. So welcome to worship today. So I'm sharing with you guys today because, you know, I told you guys my friends, so I shared something I learned last week. So as a beautiful service, right, we're going to get up, calm our minds, calm ourselves, right? So what we're going to do, take your right hand, put it on your chest, like this, and we're going to slowly move it across your chest. But as you slowly move it, I want you to form a tight fist, okay? So as you move it across your chest, whatever is in your heart and in heaven, I'm going to cap it in this fist. Okay, you guys ready?
Yeah.
So put a hand over your chest and slowly move it. Slowly forming a fist. Okay, you guys have a tight fist. What we're going to do, we're going to take it up like this way, pick your hands up, and say, God, this is for you. This is what I can do.
This is for you.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay. So let's get called to worship now. What joy it is to have you here today.
We have come from very busy lives, filled with all the joys and difficulties.
Welcome to this place where God will ease your burdens and celebrate your joys with you.
We have come to find hope and peace in our lives.
Whatever has happened this week in our life, know that God is with you and offering you peace, rest, and blessing.
Thank you, God, who accepts us as we are, and warmly welcomes us to this service of worship. Amen.
Please join me in the opening prayer. Let's put it in a bulletin. To the projector. Lord,
we have come to you this day, bringing all that we have, our lives, our hopes and dreams, our fears and sorrows. We bring our children before you, that we might know the way to your heart, as with the heart of a child.
Please
place these before you in faith and hope, knowing that no matter what has happened, you are with us and are blessing us. Open our hearts to receive your words and your spirit, that we may find healing and comfort. Open our lives to the wondrous possibilities for service and joy that you offer to us. Ease our minds and spirits, that we may hear the words of encouragement and peace this day. Amen.
My name is Gretchen Hammond, and this is just a small sample of the kids and the adults that were here all weekend. We were here Friday night, we were here yesterday morning, and here we are again, and we're excited to share with you some of the things that we did for VBS this weekend. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to share a song with you, okay? We've got a video that has the words and actions. So, I'm sorry if our backs are to you a little bit, but we just learned these songs in the last 2 days. So,
they did
a fantastic job. So, we're going to sing God is Listening for You. And if you feel so moved, you can certainly join us.
Thank you.
So we had a lot of fun. We had different music videos, and there was a lot more kids jumping and dancing, and it was a lot of fun.
You're being very shy.
Yes, yes.
That's the lowest shout I've heard all week.
So first, I definitely want to thank everybody who was involved. Mandy helped lead us in music and more and the tail end every day. Pastor Freddie and Scott helped with our Bible adventures. Deb Peroni and her granddaughters Abby and Aubrey helped with projects with a purpose. Speaking of those, we were very busy and we made our projects with a purpose. We made seed bombs. They're little bombs of potting soil and seeds.
And clay.
Yes. And they packaged them up. And we're going to have some kids standing at the doorway at the end of the service. And you are more than welcome to take some seed bombs. And you throw them in your garden or your backyard and wherever you would like some wildflowers to grow. Okay? So you may want to. Yep, or you could plant them. You could dig a little hole and you could plant them too. Okay? One of the projects that we didn't have time for were some dog toys, some braided fleece dog toys. They look like this when you're finished. So we're going to let the kids, when they're all done here, we're going to let them take them back to their seat and do some braiding during the service if they'd like, keep their hands busy. If you also would like to braid a dog toy while you listen and take it home to your pet, give it to a friend or a neighbor who might have a pet. Okay, so that's an activity that they're going to work on here. Our pet playground or outside games was very popular yesterday, run by Mr. Dan Peroni. Did a lot of fun outside. The puppy preschool playhouse was led by Joyce and Carlene Berzer. We had some fabulous crew leaders step up. People that traveled with the kids to each station and helped out. That was Sheila, Yvonne, and Teresa. We had a lot of tech support from Dana and Mallory, taking photos, running DVDs, playing music. It was fantastic. And we thank Cindy Van Asten for supplying some snacks for us on all the days. So, whole team effort. 18 kids came. We had probably just as many adults that were also here. I mean, I think at one point we counted 13 adults, but then more just kept coming. So it was fantastic. It was a really fun first big experience with the family church and all of us together. So it was a lot of fun. Let's see, we've got one more song for you. We're gonna sing Jesus Loves Me. I think maybe we could do the kind of basic so they can hear our voices better.
Jesus loves me, this I know.
you to know the thing that they got the most excited about was how her shirt kept changing.
So while the kids pass out some dog toys to make, we're going to share a little slideshow that Dana and Mallory put together for us so you can see some pictures of what we did.
What do you think? Do you think the kids did a good job?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. Take a look at, we tried to make sure that we kept at least every one of the children is in at least one of the pictures. We had something poor Dana had to put together, how was it? Couple hundred pictures that you chose from. We took pictures constantly so that we would have a memory of this first time together at Peace and Family Church to be a church together in our case. Was a dog that was part of the neighbor who helped tell the story, and who, without Dudley, I'm not so sure that it would have been nearly as much fun. I know we have the voice of Dudley, but I don't think Dudley's in here today, is he? No, I didn't think so. We're going to let this run. As we get started, we have a lot to do.
Okay, the scripture reading, what scripture reading do you think of? Psalm 127. Unless the Lord builds the house, and the builders labor in vain, unless the Lord watches over the city, the guard stands watch in vain. In vain you rise early and stay up late, toiling for food to eat, for while they sleep, you provide for those you love. Turn at the heritage for the Lord. All springs the reward from him, like arrows in the hands of a warrior, a children born in one field. Blessed is the man whose quiver is full of them. They will not be put to shame when they contend with their opponents. Second scripture reading is taken from Matthew chapter 18, verses 1 to 4. At that time, the disciples came to Jesus and said, "Who then is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven?" He called a little child to him and placed the child among them. And he said, "Truly I tell you, unless you change and become like little children, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. Therefore, whoever takes the lowly position of this child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. And whoever welcomes one such child in my name welcomes me." The third and final scripture reading is taken from Matthew chapter 19, verses 13 to 15. Then people brought little children to Jesus for him to place his hands on them and pray for them. But the disciples rebuked them. Jesus said, "Let the children come to me, and do not hinder them, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these." When he had placed his hands on them, he went on from there. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Get it out yet. Whoa, I'm on. Today's all about our children. The reason for our being today as we come together for communion and to enjoy together who we are as a community of faith, we must remember our children. sometimes we forget how important children really are. And shall we listen to the scriptures as we have read them today? Jesus thought children were the most important thing. Not because they were children, like so often we go, oh, we love the little kids. You know, if you get a baby around me, stay away. I want that baby, you know? But because children are willing to learn. That's what Jesus was saying. He wasn't saying you got to become a little kid again that way. What he was saying was you've got to come to God with the heart and mind of a child. The heart of a child that says, teach me. Show me. Let me be a sponge and learn absolutely everything you have to teach me. That's what it means to come to God as a child, to trust God to be our leader, to know that it's all been when we trust God to learn what is in front of us. Our life is to change. Have you ever thought about that when things happen in your life? And you look back on it and you say, oh, if I only would have looked at it this way, if I would have seen it just a little differently. I always used to get accused of looking at things like this. Especially when I worked in corrections. They said, how come you always seem to see things differently than anybody else? And I said, part of it's because I'm still a kid at heart, you see. All of us have that little child inside of us. My little girl sometimes gets really scared. And she just doesn't know what she's supposed to do. And if you ever see me doing this, it's because I'm trying to keep my little girl in check. My little girl has no filters. None. Any of you have a little one inside of you who has no filters? Yeah, those filters should say, I really don't like that woman's dress. Or, like one little boy said to me one day, Pastor, you gotta stop drinking coffee before children's message. Your breath stinks. Yep, that's sometimes how the little girl filter in me works too. However, as we grow up and we get told by the world we have to act a certain way, we have to treat certain people a certain way, there's a protocol for everything. When the person gets older, the protocols become even tougher to reach. You know, there's a protocol of how you're supposed to treat your boss at work. There's a protocol of how you can treat somebody you work with. Sometimes the little girl used to come out to me when I was working in Frederick. I got to admit it. And sometimes people I worked with just weren't as good as I was. Yeah, right. Sometimes, folks, as we grow up, we lose all of that childlikeness. I gotta tell you this week, if you could have been here on Friday night and Saturday morning, you'd be as tired as I am, but you would have seen a glory. There was so much excitement in this building, where people were jumping and, you know, down low, up high. I still can't jump. But we're still going to get down to the floor where some of those kids can get down. We danced. And we enjoyed. And we learned things this weekend. We learned that Jesus wants us to be the salt and the light of the world. The salt, because if we're not little salty, that's that little one that comes out once in a while. But that little one that makes things taste better. We gave them rice cakes that were awful. I mean, they were gluten-free and salt-free. Yeah, we even gave it to Dudley, which, by the way, we got to teach Dudley some man and kill to get my finger on. Anyway, and then we gave them salted popcorn. Salted popcorn tastes so much better. Even Dudley said, ooh, this tastes better. Oh, I got it, didn't I? Oh, my goodness. And then we learned about the light, how Jesus wants us to be the light of the world. And we have little lights that we turn on and off, and every once in a while, one of them wouldn't work, right? But then it would come on, and that's who we are. That's how we come to God as a little child, being willing to open our lights, not put it under a basket, but open our lights, and to show others who we are. It doesn't matter our age. We can be any age, folks, and still let our light shine. True? And then we learn about the golden rule. No, I'm not going to tell you what Dudley says. Well, maybe I will. Because Dudley told the kids not to eat yellow snow, and I said that wasn't the golden rule. The golden rule, the kids were really good about saying. The golden rule is doing to others what you want them to do to you. That's being a child. Coming to God with the heart of knowing that we can treat others well and be treated well. And when they don't treat us well, we need to be able to take the bigger, become the bigger person, if you will, and not strike back. And we also learned, well, we learned so many things. We learned that if you put seeds in a little clay pocket and you put it in the dirt, you can grow seeds. And isn't that kind of what we do when we put the Word of God into somebody's ear? I'm going to church today. You want to come with me? Hey, you know what I learned at church today? That's putting that little seed into that clay pocket inside the sand. And I have to tell you, I couldn't convince any one of the conductors standing on the floor in that room. I keep trying to figure out a way to get a new rug in that room. They wouldn't do it. Because they were following the rules. I told you, the little girl only comes up every once in a while. The kids learned the best way to be a good Christian, to be a person who goes to God right, is to give themselves away. Like Dudley told them, when his family has popcorn, then he goes around and he eats the popcorn. He gets a little salt too. Something that tastes good. Something that children can teach us is that when we give it away, when we share with others, when we let God into their lives, we get a little bit back too. That we can have something to enjoy. All of those things we learned because the kids weren't afraid to learn it. They weren't afraid to learn new songs that they'd never sung before. I mean, the words might be familiar to some of you, but for some of the kids, they didn't know the songs like Jesus Loves Me. For some of the kids, they didn't understand those things, but were they willing to learn them? Absolutely. Are you? Are you willing to learn what Jesus has put before us? Are you willing to learn how to treat others the way you want to be treated? Are you willing to learn that you are the salt and the light of the world? Are you, as adults, willing to let your little child out so that the road to heaven might be a little easier to traverse? You see, God just wants you to be willing and open and honest about your love for God. And if you can be all of those things, you are coming to God with the I pray today that each of you can find that child within and come to God with God's glory, that you might share it with others. Amen. We say, this is my Father's word.
And healing grace.
given each of us such blessings
and talents. With joy we bring these gifts to God, for you are blessed by God, by God's absolute love for you. Please join us now as we come together for the great Thanksgiving. You're going to notice that we're going to do things a little differently today, because we're going to be using the service that I would use at a nursing home, or at a hospital visit, or at a person's home if they wanted communion but didn't want to have to go through the whole setup for it. So Ed and I are going to be kind of doing a dual pastors. Ed is getting ready and studying to be the communion deacon. So there's different times you're going to find that he's going to be helping me. And I'm putting him to work. And I think it's important for all of us to understand that. Can you hear him if he talks from here?
I would talk loud.
Yeah.
Okay. Blessed are you, O God, who of your word and the Holy Spirit created all things and called them good. In Jesus Christ, the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Through Jesus Christ, suffering and death, you took upon yourselves our sin and death and destroyed your power forever. He rose from the dead, the same Jesus, who now reigns in you in glory, and poured upon us your Holy Spirit, making us the power, making us the people of the new covenant.
Now, on the night before his meeting with death, Jesus took bread. He gave thanks to you, O Father. He gave it to his disciples and said, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And when the supper was over, Jesus took the cup. Again, he gave thanks to you, O Father. And he gave it to his disciples, and he said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for the many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me."
And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ, offering for us.
Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here, and these the gifts of bread and cup. That in the breaking of this bread and the drinking of this wine, that we may know the presence of the living Christ, and be renewed as the body of Christ in the world, redeemed by Christ's blood, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his table forever.
Through Christ, with Christ, in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. And now, with the confidence of God's children, let us pray the prayer Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Please come forward as the Spirit moves you.
Thank you.
As always, I remind you that the box on this side in the back is for the collection for the family church, and the basket on that side is for peace. You can put your giving in either one, it will be fine. Please join me now in the office for a prayer.
Oh Lord, on this day, this very special day, when our children have taught us the beauty of coming to you, bless each of us in all the ways you can. Let our children be blessed by our gifts to you, as they are a gift to us. Lord, show us the way to come to you as a little child does, with awe and thanksgiving for your many gifts. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. This is awesome. for your sister and for your cousin?
Yeah.
Birthdays, you said?
Yeah.
They got birthdays. Well, this was a bit the month for birthdays. Let me count. Yes.
My grandmother passed away this past Wednesday. She was 95. She was a wonderful lady. We all loved her very much, and it's a celebration that she's gone to be with Jesus.
We know that the celebration is that she is welcomed into God's arms, most definitely. Josh, right?
Yes.
I got it right. Good. Josh's grandma passed away on Wednesday, and we must be joyous because we know that she is with God today. I don't see any other hand.
That's right.
Gracious and wonderful God, you have brought to us children who are willing to listen and learn and teach us. What a great and wonderful thing that was. And it was to your glory, God, all to your glory. We lift up all of the birthdays that are being celebrated this week or have been celebrated or are celebrated today. And we just ask that you bless each of them. We ask that you keep the weather in good form for the Lexi's graduation party today, that it would be a good and happy success. We ask that you'll be with Lima and his family as he goes through these last days. Bless them and let them know the joy that you will have welcoming them home, as you also welcome Josh and Grandma this week. All these things, Lord, we lay at your feet knowing that you care about every single one of us, whether as just like you care about the birds of the air, the flowers of the field, you care about us even more. And we're grateful for that, Lord, in more ways than you know. We pray all of this in Jesus' name. And now a special meeting.
Before we start, I would like to make an announcement. Sandy has been playing bells, I think, since she was in the bell choir many years ago. And she would like to retire. So we are looking for a new bell player. It's not a huge commitment. You practice, depending on your level of expertise, you practice a couple times a month and play usually once a month. So if you're at all interested or have questions, please talk to me and we'll give you the specifics.
Thank you.
our own comfort zone, turn to the people around you and say, God loves you.
I love you.
But there's not a darn thing you can do about it.
Find one, then be one. Go in peace.
Amen.